To our Fallout 1 playthrough. This is the first time most of us have ever played the game. I haven't even finished this game yet, so...
The game or the series?
This game, okay. Not the series.
We're all familiar. You haven't even played this, and it's on... Did you just buy this, or...?
I've had it for a while. I have played it, but I never finished it. I got really far in, and it's very possible to screw yourself and be unable to complete it.
That sounds awesome.
isn't this one the one where it's on a 150-day timer?
Yes.
Yeah.
Did you buy this for me? I forgot.
I think I did. It's $1. It was $1 on Steam when I bought it. I think it's $10 now.
And it's what, 1997?
97, yes. That's correct.
So this has a time limit, like Dead Rising does. Play.
Half the game has a time limit. The other half...
By gamers for gamers.
Interplay.
Epic gamer moment.
Can we get an epic gamer moment count?
4x3.
Brian Fargo.
This is my favorite Fallout intro of all time.
I believe this is also before Bethesda.
Yes. Bethesda existed, but
they didn't have it. It was like pre-Bethesda.
Nothing came so this was Fallout 76.
So this was made by
Black Isle Studios
ever made.
And then they bought the series from Black Isle Studios, which later became
Obsidian. Don't shoot him! Oh, he's twitching! Maybe.
It's fun to shoot civilians.
At the camera.
That was just...
I'm doing my part.
I'm doing my part by shooting civilians.
Will prove untrue. Then what will you do?
600
horsepower. Text.
Wow. 0 to 60 in a half a second.
$200,000. Holy shit.
Nuclear-powered cars. Yes, that's what we're missing out on.
But
I love the aesthetic of Fallout, man, so much.
I like the aesthetic of the original games somewhat better than the new ones.
A little, yeah. But I'm surprised how consistent that Bethesda remained to them.
Mm-hmm.
Bethesda, also Obsidian.
War never changed.
And Obsidian, yeah.
The Romans waged war to gather slaves and wealth. Spain built an empire from its lust for gold and territory. Hitler shaped a battered Germany into an economic superpower. But war never changes. In the 21st century, war was still waged over the resources that could be acquired. Only this time, spoils of war were also its weapons. Petroleum and uranium. For these resources, China would invade Alaska, the US would annex Canada, and the European Commonwealth would dissolve into quarreling, bickering nations.
See, in 97, this seems like a satire. In 2020, we don't even know if this could be real.
Yeah.
World War had come again. In 2 brief hours, most
the world's on fire.
To cinders. And from the ashes of nuclear devastation, a new civilization would struggle to arise. A few were able to reach the relative safety of the large underground vaults. Your family was part of that group that entered Vault 13. Imprisoned safely behind the large vault door, under a mountain of stone, a generation has lived without knowledge of the outside world. Life in the vault is about to change.
Right. You know, I take that back. I think Fallout 2 has my favorite intro.
Oh, okay. So, one experiment was Vault 13.
Like, we'll find out.
Spoilers.
I guess. Yeah.
I'll go.
But you don't find out till Fallout
2. So I don't need to adjust anything?
Yeah, it's already adjusted.
I have such a habit on PC of just going and starting a new game and.
You gotta click the little button, dude. Little button next to new game.
Fine.
So we can either create. We can either use a pre-created character or make our own.
No, we're making
our own.
Go to create character, not modify. Yeah, that's.
Weird. I think the thing with the first two Fallouts is that it had a lot.
So we're gonna be spending like 2 hours.
One intelligence, and 10 strength.
Oh, God.
Okay, no.
Root gameplay.
No, let's not.
John did tell us that it's almost impossible to beat the game if you have intelligence 0 or 1.
Yeah, don't do that. It's funny as hell because everyone's like, why did the Overseer choose you?
Yeah. But I think the thing with the first two...
I know.
With the first two Fallouts, they had a lot more, like, fucked up concepts.
Yes, they did.
And Bethesda toned it down when they got a hold of Fallout 3. New Vegas went back up there a little bit, but nothing like what these
had. Don't put it all into intelligence. What the hell are you doing?
I'm heroic if I'm intelligent.
Omnipotent.
Okay, so, how about 7? Very good intelligence.
Okay, yeah, I would suggest at the very least having like a good strength, like 6 or 7, because that helps our carry weight and what weapons we can use.
And you know what?
Can I take things out of luck? I always take things out of luck.
It's actually somewhat useful in this.
Okay.
Perception.
You know what?
You're gonna want perception. At least six.
Okay. You know what? How about take 1 out of agility, and then take 1 out of charisma. I know we love charisma, but let's just take it out of that for the sake of.
I know.
I want to talk people down from killing me.
I know my usual is 7 charisma, 7 intelligence, and 6 strength, and I think 6 perception.
So should I just go 6 strength?
Or? Mine's 1 intelligence, and then max out strength, and endurance, and agility.
So, strength affects like what weapons you can use, your carry weight. Perception like affects how like the chances of you being able to hit the enemy.
Oh, and these are bats? They have bats?
Pretty much.
That's the only way you can hit on
deception.
Yeah.
Dang, that's like instead of actually aiming.
Endurance is how many hit points you have.
If you didn't know, combat is turn based on here.
Yeah.
It's not free floating like on the new ones.
It's RPG beat.
It's turn based RPG. Yes.
Yeah.
Oh shit! I like this a little more.
Like, agility is like. With agility, I think that like affects your chance to also hit enemies. But and
coordination.
If you have,
and
this,
the
is basically,
to move well,
this is basically D&D
agility
graphics. Is what
for
it
any
is.
Active mm-hmm. character modifies action points, armor class, sequence, and many skills.
I think if you have really low agility, you'll keep dropping your gun because of the recoil.
I'm out of.
Put like I, you know what? Up. Put like 1 out of luck. Because, just 1, I think, won't hurt much to have just fair luck.
If you have low luck, the thing is...
Well, I mean, that's not low luck. It's...
Yeah.
It's fair.
Yeah, it's possible if you do that you might end up, like, getting ambushed by rat scorpions and it's impossible to get away or something.
You know what? We could take 1 out of courage.
Well, we'll see how the dice roll.
Can we upgrade any of these at a later point?
Yeah, you
like
can.
Like how with then, perks.
Uh huh.
Okay.
Yeah, if you get perks every 5 levels.
If we can upgrade, because
that's what I usually do with like New Vegas, where because they had a video on YouTube where it's like, here's how to fully maximize your character for maximum utility, and I'm like, wow, I could have done this because there's like this thing where you can get like even more points to stats.
Uh huh.
When you level
stamina
up
stamina and physical toughness. The character with a high endurance will survive where others may not. Modifies hit points, poison and radiation resistance, healing rate, and the additional hit points per level.
Yeah, we could put it to like 1 more endurance and call it there.
And then you gotta tag some skills.
Yeah. And we gotta choose our age and gender.
Because we get tagged, don't we?
Yes.
Yeah, then... The sacrificing luck for now is better.
Okay, so what's our skills at? Small guns, 48. Big guns, no. Unarmed is pretty good. Melee weapons, 61.
I'd say tag speech.
First aid.
First aid's not too bad.
Is small guns like anything rifles?
Small guns
we're
is pistols
like,
and submachine guns.
We're pretty balanced.
Okay.
Any one-handed weapon.
Put more into big guns, because that on here, that's rifles, too, from what John's saying.
The one into speech.
Click on it first and see what it get the details.
The operation and maintenance of really big guns.
Okay, then small guns, maybe.
Small guns is, like, all the other guns, like pistols and...
I mean...
SMGs and rifles.
Okay.
Put even more
I didn't
into
know
that.
It counted rifles.
Put even more into it.
Okay,
because we're going to want that off
do
the
I
bat.
Do I click this? Or?
Yeah.
Yeah. 60%.
Okay, yeah, that's
pretty good.
That's good at the start.
Yeah.
First aid, maybe, too.
I would go speech.
Speech, definitely.
Oh, yeah.
Speech is 55%, yeah. Well, actually, our barter and speech is pretty good.
75.
That's even better.
Jeez.
Either...
Barter?
Either lockpick, first aid, or...
Yeah, honestly, lockpick, because that's what I usually just run for, like...
Yeah.
Because
so
you always want to get all the good
all
stuff.
All in favor of lockpick?
Aye.
Sure.
Yeah.
65. Yeah, that's pretty good.
All right, let's choose our age and gender, which actually affect the game.
57
that's
years old.
Cool. I don't need to save anything here, right?
No. Yeah, you can. Oh, okay. I think the minimum age you can be is 16, and the maximum is like 40.
We started playing D&D, so this kind of like it free flows. like all of this, I'm like this.
Oh,
stats.
35 is the. Max.
Put them young, because they may actually be better.
Oh, God!
You can make them... Nah, man.
20.
Child soldier.
20. Just put
he's legal!
No, you gotta make the joke where he's not even... Like, he's seen so much shit, but he's not even old enough to drink.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
And,
that's funny.
And, gender does actually affect dialogue and certain quests.
That makes sense.
Like, if you play as a female character, some people are like, I don't know, you don't look strong enough.
That's kind of...
So sexist, sexism, sick.
Yeah, I like that.
But can you pull a Benny on people?
Yes.
That might be worth it.
Let's play as a male character. Or, well, I don't care, whichever you want.
Coin flip?
We
stop railroading us, John.
Quick, we need a D2.
Well, I don't know. It depends. Depends on how hard you want it.
Oh, if we can Benny people while being a female.
You can do it as both, honestly.
Nah, let's just go male then. That's fine.
What are the optional traits? What are those, John?
They're like perks.
Can you pick them or no?
Yeah, you can pick up to 2, I believe.
Bloody mess is not even worth it.
No.
That is like the worst.
Bloody mess is like...
Small frame, man.
Your metabolic rate is twice normal. This means that you are much less resistant to radiation and poison, but your body heals faster.
That's not worth it.
Ooh, Camera Lion, do that one.
A little slower, but a little bigger. You may not hit as often, but they will feel it when you do. Wait, when you do. Your total action points are... Lowered, but your strength is increased.
Mm. What's a night person?
I mean, that's not worth it.
What's a night person?
I think night person is you get like an advantage in night, but you get a disadvantage in day.
Yeah.
Which is not worth it.
I sometimes...
You sell with single-handed weapons, but two-handed weapons cause a problem. Finesse, which means you're probably not going to get hit as much. Your attacks show a lot of finesse. You don't do as much damage, but you cause more critical hits.
That's pretty good.
Sometimes I do kamikaze.
By not paying attention to any threats, you can act a lot faster in a turn. This lowers your armor class to just what you are wearing, but you sequence much faster in a combat turn.
In New Vegas, it's you take -1 endurance.
All these other ones called skilled and gifted.
Yeah, gifted might be good.
Heavy-handed, fast shot, which reduces accuracy, I'm assuming, but you shoot faster. Yeah.
Bloody mess is not jinxed. The good thing is that everyone around you has more critical failures in combat. The bad thing is, so do you. that's great.
Everyone's rolling a nat 1.
Even you.
I just shot myself in the foot.
So did I. You studied less combative skills as you were growing up. Your combat skills start at a lower level, but your first aid Dr. Speech and Butter are substantially improved.
So, I usually have that one, but it doesn't have that much of a disadvantage on New Vegas.
I know, but yeah, because we have already...
I like that
it
they
kind of balances
have pros
out.
And cons.
Yeah. Chem Reliant. Oh yeah, it's the one where you like...
Yeah,
you need drugs.
Where's Logan's loophole when you need it?
Skill.
Since you spent more time improving your skills than a normal person, you start with better skill levels. The trade-off is that you do not gain as many extra abilities. You will gain a perk every 4 levels.
Instead of 10.
Every 2 levels you gain a perk. But
yeah.
You get more points every level? Is that what it's saying?
You get more points for your skills, but you don't get any perks. Because normally it's every 2 levels you get one. This is going to make it every 4.
What's gifted? What's the last one?
I usually take gifted, but unless it's
different. You have more innate abilities than most, so you have not spent as much time honing your skills. The primary statistics are each +1, but you lose -18% on all skills to start and receive a 5 less skill points per level.
That's not worth it. That's not worth it, because, I don't know, that would just kind of...
I think
finesse
her.
Is a good
one.
One
of them.
Yeah, okay, finesse.
You don't do as much damage, but you cause more critical hits, which
yeah.
could help a lot. Did you want to choose that one, or...?
Yeah, let's go with finesse. I think you choose 2, right?
I think so.
Okay. Finesse and what else? We don't have to choose any other trait.
A little slower, but a little bigger. You may not hit as often, but they will feel it when you do. Your total action... So, would these counteract each other?
Well, action points means that, like... That's how many times you can attack.
Yeah.
Which
in
if you have Bruiser... Turn. Yeah, and if you have Bruiser, that could mean that you can only attack once.
Look what it said in action points. It went from 7 to 5.
Yeah.
But we have 9 strength now.
Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, for some things, some guns will take like 8 action points to shoot, which can cause problems, or 6 action points to shoot.
I think this is good enough for this.
I would go with skilled, to be honest.
Yeah. Because when you get down to it, when you get to higher levels, you just don't want to use some of the perks, like, when you get to that level.
A lot of the perks are not as necessary.
You know what? Yeah, get Bruiser off and go to skill, because that sounds better.
Besides, we can get companions, too.
We can compensate
we didn't name our character yet.
Oh, crap.
Okay.
His name will be name.
None.
Hold on, we just gotta really think about it.
Bleh.
There we go. Bleh. His name. Oh, wait, we're not playing a retarded character, that's right.
Huh.
Reginald.
Type it.
Reginald? R-E-G?
I-N-A-L-D.
Okay.
Reginald.
That's Reynold.
Reynold.
That's perfect.
Reynold. Yeah, Reynold.
Honestly,
perfect. His name is Reynold.
Honestly, that's
Reynold.
Great.
I typed a G, but it didn't detect it on my stupid keyboard.
Reynold.
Reynold. Wait, is it Reynold? Yeah.
Reynold.
Reynold.
Reynold. Okay.
Reynold. Oh, Reynold.
Yes. All right.
Okay, it's not Reynold. It's Reynold.
All right. Options?
All right, let's look at our armor. We can't change that, but that's what we got.
Armor class is 5. Action point 7. Carry weight 288.
So in D&D terms, you get hit by everything.
Yes.
Ouchie. Mm-hmm. Ouchie.
Damage resistance 8%. Poison resistance 38% for some reason. Radiation resistance 12%. Sequence 12. Healing rate 2. Critical chance.
I guess
14%.
I guess 12% for radiation is okay at the start, because I think in New Vegas you get none.
Mm-hmm.
So.
But the systems in this are different. So
far different. Yeah. I mean, in New Vegas, they're similar, but...
What are the options?
I don't think they're... I think they're just, like, settings, like, screen and stuff.
Done. Everyone agree on Reynold?
Reynold.
Yeah, I agreed.
Yep.
What?
Reynold?
I thought you said no.
Reynold.
Again, where's Logan's loophole when you need it?
Noah, stop being
a
contrarian for 5 seconds.
Reynold.
Ah!
Ha! You're here. Good. We've got a problem. A big one. The controller chip for our water purification system has given up the ghost. Can't make another one, and the process is too complicated for a workaround system. Simply put, we're running out of drinking water. No water, no vault. This is crucial to our survival. And frankly, I think you're the only hope we have. You need to go find us another controller chip. We estimate we have 4 to 5 months before the vault runs out of water. We need that chip. We marked your map with the location of another vault. Not a bad place to start, I think. Look, just be safe, okay?
Okay, so I guess that's what you mean by the first 150 days.
This is it.
Surprisingly well kept.
See, this wouldn't have been a problem if you guys invented the microprocessor. But you guys are idiots and didn't invent that.
Nuclear!
You guys are idiots and didn't invent that in this universe. This is your punishment for being ignorant.
Man, look at that 3D cave.
Scary.